Yo guys, welcome back. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe so you can catch the spills every week. And don't forget to hit that bell up top so we can squad up in the comments for the first hour. Alright, so going back to like November, like 3 months ago, we recently talked about Laura Kenny meeting up with Team Weapon X, and we knew this was gonna eventually happen because we even talked about that like a month or so prior to it actually happening. But at the time, we really didn't know how it was gonna go down. But as it turned out, the team ended up needing her help because the Weapon X program that either created or enhanced many of them started back up again. And they wasn't just making Wolverines this time, they was making Hulk Wolverines. Kinda like they got a letter from corporate that said go hard or go home. And this was the primary mindset of Reverend Stryker. And in this process, he recruited people who were hurt by or disliked mutants. And he brewed much of their dislike into a hatred, and after that was done, they would pretty much be begging to be a part of his program. Which in turn either had you turn into a cyborg, and if you felt like you were a true believer, then you would enter the Batch H program. And I'll leave a link in the description for anybody who's new and need to catch up on that before they come back to this, because that Weapon of Mutant Destruction storyline wasn't just your introduction to Weapon H, but it also tied into the birth of your Weapon X team, and it broke ground for a new volume of the Weapon X series that would create more or less your common space for your Wolverine related characters to eventually end up crossing paths at some point. And we see that continue in Marvel Legacy All New Wolverine. And after the events that we saw take place with Weapon X, we're introduced to the Orphans of X, who are a secret hate group for mutants, whose origin goes back to a specific issue that we covered at a particular time where we were talking more about Weapon X. And that's like a video I did like a year ago. I think that video still has like 7,000 views or something like that. And I had like 120, 130 subscribers at the time. Total, like everybody. And I got a screenshot somewhere. I'll find it and I'll show you guys. We come a long way. It's crazy, but either way, Orphan of X. Now, their agenda is very similar to William Stryker. They want all mutants dead, but more specifically Laura Kenny, and really just anybody associated with her. And because of that, anyone they can get their hands on who was Wolverine related, and not even blood related, but closely associated with Wolverine, they got bumped to the top of the list. And this is where we pick up with Doc Kent. And recently, he's been laying low for a minute, and kinda just popping up here and there. And since we talked about him last, he had his run-ins with Iceman, and he had appeared previously in All New Wolverine as well. And it was like All New Wolverine issue 20, or 21, somewhere around there. And at that time, Dr. Strange had brought in Doc Kent, Old Man Logan, and Deadpool for backup, but also this backup had to be people with individual healing factors. And the main reason why is because at this time on Roosevelt Island, there was this alien plague going crazy, and they were the only ones who could really do anything about it. But that was one of the first times in a long while that Laura Kenny had seen Doc Kent. And it really had just been her and Gabby for a while. And Gabby, who was a younger clone of X-23, but it really had been just them two for a good minute. But it's funny though, like right when they showed up, Gabby and Deadpool were friends off the rip. Then Deadpool gets shot and they just leave him. But he gets right back up though, he's good. He's just like, what I miss? And that's just Deadpool all day. But back to Doc Kent, while he's at this bar and he's in the middle of nowhere, like literally, and this random guy just walks up to him like, hey, you're that guy from Roosevelt Island. What's your name again? Dakin? Hey, everybody, it's Dakin. Dakin, 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 Dakin. It's Dakin. And he's really just making the scene like, hey, let me buy you a drink, man. You're a hero. But at this point, Doc Kent is here to meet somebody. He lets him know that, but he doesn't say who he's here to meet. But this stranger insists on getting him a glass of whiskey. And mind you, Doc Kent, he just wanted water. So off rip, this whole situation looking suspect. And this is Doc Kent, the son of Wolverine. He smells the poison in the drink. He smells the stench of everyone around him nervous. And he quickly puts together like, okay, this meetup was really a setup. And he toys with that guy a little bit because he's the most nervous of all, because he knows when it jumps off, he the first one to get it. So Doc Kent offers him the drink, then some random dude just breaks character. And when that dude goes for him, that really confirms everyone's true nature. Like, that was the first moment of truth in that bar that night, including the call from whoever it was for him to meet at this location. And the person who set him up was well aware that he could take out everybody in this bar. They know who he is and what he's capable of, and that's when everything kind of flips. Because it goes from your classic roadhouse bar fight, shout out to Patrick Swayze, but it goes from your bar fight to the bartender coming out from behind the bar with an electric net gun. And Doc Kent is like, who brings an electric net gun to a bar fight? Where they do that at? But what's crazy is once they have him constrained, they reveal that they are members of the Orphans of X. And at this point, he didn't know who the orphans were, why they're orphans, who was their daddy. Like, all this is new. But the crazy thing about this is that these people risk their lives in order to inflict this damage on Doc Kent. Because as soon as they tell him who they are, everyone dips out, but they're just yards away from an incoming missile. And I'm no expert on the blast radius of a missile versus the pickup of a F-150, like a pickup truck, but I'm pretty certain that 15 and a half out of 16 people would have died trying to get away from that. But as far as Lord Kenny, who's the all-new Wolverine, if the Orphans of X had a number order of who they wanted the most, she definitely would be number one. And it's not just because she was directly cloned from Wolverine, but there's a particular, much more personal vendetta that ties into it as well. And the way that this unfolds, after the incident with Doc Ken at the bar, Lord Kenny gets a phone call from Officer Thompson. And the reason why is because someone has left Doc Ken's arm as a message and a warning, with only a note attached with the symbol of the Orphans of X. And once again, it's not like when they see the symbol or they hear of the name, they tie the two together and they know who they are. This group is 100% underground. And the only way that Laura Kenny really ties it together is because this paper with the symbol smells like the Weapon X location where she was created. And so she makes that painful visit back to the place where she was created and effectively used as a weapon to take out multiple targets, and one of the very last ones being her own mother. And for the record, it's not like she walked all the way out here. She called in the favor with Angel and he took her out there via chopper. And he also served as emotional support as well too, with her going back through this terrible and dark place from her past. But when she gets there and she's looking for Doc Ken, a number of familiar locations at this facility, they all just bring back a number of flashbacks. But while searching through this place, which seems to be abandoned, she finds somebody who's barely alive being contained within a cylinder. And her first thought is this gotta be Doc Ken, because this is where the trail stops, or where the scent specifically led her to. And aside from this one person in this container, no one else is there at this time. But what's crazy, as soon as she breaks this person out, she finds out that it's her mother. Yes, her mother that she killed, still being held by Weapon X. And that leaves you to think, well, if she's here, where's Doc Ken? Well, at this particular time, he's in the process of getting his other arm cut off. And man, I don't know what it is with people in Doc Ken's arms. It's like, gotta catch them all. Like, people just gotta have them. But either way, with Doc Ken, you may get one, but he ain't about to let you get both. And much like Laura Kenny surprises people with her third claw being displaced in comparison to Wolverine, with him having all three come out the backside of his hand, a lot of people make the mistake with Doc Ken or Laura Kenny that their claws are set up the same way, and this usually gives them the advantage to surprise somebody with that third claw. But this dude Ian, who's the guy who's trying to take Doc Ken's other arm, he's more or less an idiot, because when he switched shifts with some woman named Lisa, Lisa cut off the left arm and she was like, I can't do this anymore, and he took over. He didn't bother to check Doc Ken just to make sure he was secure, he just jumped right into brutally interrogating him. But either way, Doc Ken, who was laying naked on the table, took all of Ian's clothes in order to sneak out. If he was smart, he would have took his arm too and like put it in a sling or something, and that way it would have looked a bit more convincing. But on his way out, he hears a conversation between Sarah Kenny, Laura Kenny, and Gabby. And this video is from a surveillance feed at Laura's current location. But it's pretty important that he stuck around and eavesdropped here, because this is how he found out one of the ways that the Orphans of X was getting their information. But when he makes a noise and Ian's either wife or girlfriend hears him, at first she thought it was Ian, because Doc Ken's wearing his clothes. But when she seen that he only had one arm, she immediately knew that Ian was gone. Because Doc Ken clearly has a history, we've seen what he did with Punisher. And the thing is, if you cross him and he gets loose, you're done. But in this situation, he only got one arm. They got hella dogs. There's men outside, he's taking a barrage of bullets, and he desperately just needs to get out of there. And it's crazy the way he does it, because he just picks up one of the dogs by the collar and throws him at the dude in the car, then kicks the two of them out of the car. But after seeing that surveillance feed that he saw back in the house before he got caught, he's been made aware it's a whole spill of information that he needs to tell Laura Kenny. And after he shakes the Orphans of X, that's where he goes directly to. And so at this point, as far as what these two know about the Orphans of X organization, a majority of that information is coming from Doc Ken and Sarah Kenny. Because before Doc Ken got here, Sarah had told Laura when they brought her back that they were after Laura. And she explained that they constantly questioned her, asking her about Laura. But more importantly, Sarah told Laura that the people after her know about the Muramasa Blade. And so, as a lot of you may already know, the Muramasa Blade in Marvel Comics is a sword that was forged with a portion of Wolverine's soul. And he had done this many years back when Itsu, Doc Ken's mother, who was pregnant with Doc Ken at the time, had been murdered. And there are two Muramasa Blades, at least I can think of, in Marvel Comics. The other one's also known as the Black Blade. But this one, forged by Wolverine's soul, was also fused with some of Doc Ken's claws when he went up against Wolverine. And it's the same sword that Wolverine used when he decapitated Sabretooth. But later on, when Wolverine went up against Doc Ken, he removed the claws that he had fused with parts of the blade, and Wolverine took the remains of the blade and Doc Ken's claws that were fused with it and buried them in a secret location. But for anybody who's completely new to this or the whole concept of the Muramasa Blade, it is the one substance that if it cuts any of these guys, even with their healing factor, they will not heal from it. And when Laura's talking to Doc Ken, catching him up on everything about Sarah coming back, and how she's helping them here at her aunt's house, both Megan and Debbie, Dokken's main concern is if Laura mentioned to her anything about the Muramasa blade, because he knows they've been talking for a while and Laura knows where it's at. But instead of just answering him, she only tells him that she has it taken care of. And Dokken's like, huh, you do? Do you really? And he just lets off on Sarah. And I'm not talking like a shot in the shoulder or anything like that. Like, he goes for the kill. And Laura, who is so happy to have her mother back, loses her mother again. And she is triggered instantly. And for you guys that's read this, you already know, for the better part of like 3 or 4 pages, she gets the carving Dokken like it's Thanksgiving and he's the turkey, because she just blacks out and the red that was in her eyes looks much like the red that was in her eyes when she was under the triggered serum. And I talk more about that in another video that I did about a year ago. But Dokken was really trying to tell Laura what he found out when he was being held captive in that house, because when he saw that surveillance footage, he found out that wasn't Laura's mother. And when the body's eyes opened back up and this dude from another location started talking through her body, at that point it was like, okay, yeah, not the mama. But this was a message being spoken to Laura Kenny from the leader of the Orphans of X. He told her that there was hundreds of them and they will stop at nothing until her kind is no more. But just to give you guys an idea of what's been going on kind of in the background, the Children of X have been busy, because when Laura first brought her mother home, she tricked Laura into making a plan which would expose the location of the Muramasa blade. And she did that by telling her that the people who were after Laura, they knew where it was and they need to get rid of it. And that's when Laura called Carol Danvers and told her, hey, I need you to go to this location, find this item, and just throw it into the sun. But Laura didn't know that that was a setup for her to actually give up the location so that the Orphans of X who were listening would be able to go there and get it themselves. But at this point, when Laura found out that she had been set up, she quickly tried to contact Captain Marvel, but at this point, it was too late. And when the Orphans of X arrived, they caught Captain Marvel off guard using a suit that they'd designed to face mutants. But had Laura Kenny told Carol Danvers just a little bit earlier, this whole instance right here would have went down a little bit differently. And they hear it happen over the phone. So Dokken's like, oh, they got it, we gotta go. They now have the pieces of the Muramasa blade, and outing all these guys just got a whole lot easier for them. So they literally dress Dokken in whatever they can find and they get out of there. But now that the Orphans of X have all the remaining pieces of the Muramasa blade, not only do they crank up their search for Laura Kenny, but they also use pieces of it to make bullets. And when they did this, they would have their secret meetings, but this one was important. They had everybody there, like even Patrick Stewart. Nah, I'm playing, that's not Patrick Stewart, but it looked like him though. Let me find out, he out here trying to get rid of mutants. But the way they had this set up, it was a public execution of these mutants that they had captured. And what they did was offer the opportunity to a few select members for them to perform the execution. And man, they got Logan, Sabretooth, and Lady Deathstrike. And moments before it actually takes place, like they're about to do this whole speech thing, and Logan interrupts right in the middle of it. And he's like, if you're gonna do it, just do it. And she's just like, oh, okay. And that is the end of Logan, Sabretooth, and Lady Deathstrike. Just like that. But that's it for this one, guys. I got part 2 coming up pretty soon. In that one, I'll break down a bit more about the Orphans of X and their ties with the Hand. But if you enjoyed the video, smash that like button. If you're completely new here to the channel, be sure to subscribe so you can catch the spills every week. And we'll do it again next time. All right, later.